Hey y'all, so today I wanted to share a recipe with you that I found on Pinterest, I don't know, probably a couple years ago at this point. I really, really, really enjoy it. It's not difficult to make, but it's so good and there's versatile. There's a couple of different things that you can do with it. So I think that if you get a chance to make it, you'll really enjoy it too. So today we are going to be making homemade Nutter Butters, so essentially peanut butter cookies with a peanut butter cream filling. They are as wonderful as they sound. I mean, you guys, woo, they're so good. Okay, so there's just a few ingredients that it takes to make these cookies. Again, sometimes some of these recipes, it's not a lot of ingredients. It's just developing your skill, developing your technique, and the more that you do it, the better you're gonna be. And I'm excited for you guys to make these things. I really cannot wait. So let's go ahead and talk about these ingredients. I'm making one full recipe as it is written. Now, again, I found this recipe. I have not changed it. It is absolutely wonderful the way that it's written. I will post a link to the recipe. It's from a blog called Cookies and Cups, and I've got my recipes up here hanging up for me so that I have everything I need. And again, I mentioned before that it's great if you're making a recipe that you're not familiar with, or even if you're making a recipe that you've made 100 times, to go ahead and get your stuff together before you get started making and mixing. That way you know you have everything, the correct measurements. You don't get flustered and forget something, or oh my gosh, was that 2 teaspoons? How many did I put already? So it's really great to go ahead and get your stuff together, okay? We call it, in a culinary school, I was taught that it's called mise en place, and that's just having all of your things together so that you can prepare your recipe and keep it moving, okay? It's kind of just having all your junk together, breaking it down for you. So this recipe is gonna require a cup of softened. Remember, we spoke about how you wanted to just leave your butter out. Get up in the morning, pop it on the counter, pop it on your shelf, go to work, come home, make your stuff. You can soften it in the microwave if you need to, but again, you want it just softened, like room temperature. I can kind of stick my finger in this. It's not melted, but it's nice and soft for us. So it takes a cup of melted butter. Y'all, we ain't using margarine, okay? Don't bring no country crock up in here. I'm not hating. There are some things that you can use margarine for, but y'all, this calls for butter, okay? All right, so let's buy some butter. And it's gonna take 2 sticks, or, you know, 1 cup of butter. It's gonna take 1 cup of granulated white sugar. This recipe is gonna use a couple different kinds of sugar. We're gonna use white sugar, we're gonna use brown sugar. I keep, again, in these tins, and I want to show you how to measure this, so we'll get to that in just a second. But 1 cup of brown sugar, 1 cup of white granulated sugar. It's gonna take 1 cup of peanut butter. Now, I use creamy peanut butter. You can use crunchy peanut butter in this. If that is your thing, use it. It'll give your cookies just a little bit more of a crunch. If that's your thing. I don't like crunchy peanut butter, not a crunchy person, but it will make up perfectly fine in that. And then we of course need a couple eggs, our vanilla extract, and in this bowl we have 2.5 cups of flour. And then I also have 1 teaspoon of baking powder and 1 teaspoon of baking soda. Okay, they're a little bit more white than that flour is, so you can see that they're there, hopefully. But we've got those as our dry ingredients, okay? And so again, butter, sugar, peanut butter, eggs, flour, vanilla, leavening, okay? All right, so we're gonna go ahead and get started making this recipe, okay? So just gonna add in our mixer. You can definitely use a hand mixer to make this. Just get your, the recipe calls for us to add our butter and our peanut butter and then both of our sugars in the bowl. And we're gonna start creaming that. And as mentioned in our cream cheese video, or our cheesecake video, you buy your butter in 1 pound blocks typically. Okay, I'm gonna show you this. Sorry, I messed him up. Make sure that you get all that extra butter off there, okay? If it calls for a cup of butter, that was part of your cup of butter. Okay, we wanna make sure that we get that. So make sure our recipe is gonna come out as well as we need it to, okay? All right, we're gonna put our white sugar in here. And we'll get our peanut butter, just a cup of peanut butter measured out. Bit of that left in there. And now we just need to get our brown sugar. I wanted to show you guys this. Okay. They've been wanting to roll. Okay. So I just keep my brown sugar in the bag in this container. It keeps it nice and soft. And about to be all over the counter. So for brown sugar, it's packed brown sugar. So what you want to do is just, I stick my cup in here. Okay. And I'll just press it down. And it's okay. I'm going to get this everywhere, but that's okay. I'll clean it up. It's fine. I'm okay with it. Okay. What we're going to do is just pack it. Okay. And then we can use a knife, but you can level it off. But you see, that's pretty level already. But you want that nice and packed, okay? Because that's going to give the exact amount that the recipe calls for. Okay. So we're going to pack that. Dump it in there. So, put that mess to the side there. All right, we're just gonna kind of mix our own. And let it do its thing, which is cream, okay? We want to get this nice and creamy. Not just till it's just mixed in. We want to make sure that it's lighter in color. We incorporated enough air into it so that our cookies will spread nicely. You want to be careful to not over cream this, okay? I know there's, it's like, wait, you just said cream, but don't over cream. What you talking about, girl? So we're just going to let this go for a little bit. And what you want to do is notice the color. Right now, this is looking a darker shade of just like a peanut butter color, okay? But we see that. But what we want is this to be a little bit lighter. So kind of take note of the color of your mixture after you get everything incorporated, and then just we want to let it beat for a couple minutes, and then it's going to be lighter. It's already starting to get a little lighter in color, but we just want it to get a little lighter in color. That means that our sugars are well incorporated into our butter. It's got a lot, it's got enough air in it, and everything, like I said, is nice and mixed, and we're going to have a really, really great product. The secret to making a good cookie is to make sure that you have your dough creamed well, okay? So that's why you want softened butter and not butter straight out of the fridge that's half melted that you popped in the fridge. Try to get it as soft as possible by leaving it out on the counter, or be very, very careful and just microwave it for 10 seconds at a time, maybe, until it's softer, okay? You don't want to use a melted butter. It's like, oh, well, I'll just use melted butter. It will make a difference in how your cookie bakes up, okay? So it's really important that we just want to make sure that we get this a little bit lighter. So you just kind of let it cream for a couple minutes, okay? You wanna set a timer for 2 minutes and walk away, or set a timer, 2 minutes max, and walk away, come back, and then look at your mixture. And our mixture's getting there. It's almost there. But we wanna maybe just get it a little bit lighter, yeah. Let's go ahead and get a look in that bowl. And you can see the difference, and hopefully you're able to see the difference in the color of that, and also the consistency, the texture. It's different. It's way different than what it was just a couple minutes ago. And another trick is, so right there, so what we're going to do is you can take your spatula. Again, you guys, rubber spatula, super, super important, okay? And we're going to kind of scoop down on the bottom side of the bowl. Now, if you see, it's a little bit darker at the bowl than it is. Your product on the base of the bowl is a little bit darker than your product, you know, on the top. All right, and that's what you want to see. That's how you know you've gotten some good kind of creaming, okay? And we're just going to stop and scrape this, because we stop and scrape often. dough. Because if you overmix your dough, you can make your cookies spread a lot more than they're supposed to. And we don't want them to do that. They'll be really thin, and they'll have like these really weird looking edges, super, super crispy parts, and super like parts that aren't really done. I'm gonna take this bowl off of here, okay? And again, we're just gonna scrape it well. Bring that what's on the bottom up to the middle so that when I put that paddle back down in there, it's gonna get mixed in good. Alright. Now we're gonna put this on the back on the mixer. Let that run for a couple more seconds before we add in. Let's go and put our vanilla in so that I don't forget it. Calls for 2 teaspoons of vanilla. When you get excited about your ingredients, I don't know if that's weird or what, but that's just who I am. But I get really excited about my ingredients. Makes this fun. That's what makes it fun. So we're going to go ahead and add in our dry ingredients, okay? Our flour and our leavings. Come see this dough. All right, so you see it's almost together. You want to make sure definitely at this part that we do not overmix it, because again, then we're going to overwork that gluten. It makes for a tougher cookie, and then our cookies are going to do some weird stuff in the oven. They're going to start spreading and be the shape of Texas mixed with Oklahoma over to California, okay? We want to make sure we get a nice round or whatever shape cookie that you're looking for, but not all this craziness. Again, stop and scrape your bowl. I think I'm getting cookie dough everywhere, but it happened. All right, again, I'm going in for like just a few more seconds because I don't want to overmix it. Done. Okay. And so what we're gonna do now, totally forgot to get my plastic wrap out. Because what we need to do now is we need to put our dough in the refrigerator. This is not a dough that you can make and then take it straight to the oven and bake it. It will be like peanut butter soup that bakes into one big weird, yeah, we're just not doing. Okay, I don't like this plastic wrap. Anyways, good Lord, where's that? So what we're gonna do, get a piece of plastic wrap out, okay? And then we're gonna put this dough in the refrigerator. We're gonna let it chill for at least an hour. At this point, you can make this dough and refrigerate it, I think probably for up to a week, or you can freeze it, just like this, for months, y'all. I'm serious. I've done it. I've done all of the above, okay? This dough is so wonderful. It's so forgiving. It's just so nice. It makes an excellent, excellent cookie. I did not get enough plastic wrap. Whatever. So, another tip. Okay, we have a lot of dough in here. This makes a fair amount of cookies, you guys. We have a lot of dough. So, what I'm going to do, actually, is split this in half. If I split this in half, it will to chill. Of course, it's gonna chill faster. So again, that's where I'm at. I'm about, let's getting it done faster. So plop just about half of this dough down on this piece of plastic wrap. Okay, and then what we're gonna do, just kind of fold it over, press it down, fold it over again. Just make kind of an ish little squarish ish ish, y'all, ish shape. Okay, and then I'm gonna wrap that one more time in plastic wrap. Cause this stuff is working so beautifully for me. Oh my Lord. I'm just gonna wrap it one more time just to protect it from any odors you may have in your refrigerator and to make sure that it's nice and covered. Okay, so I'm gonna do the same thing with the second one, get everything straightened up, and we are going to come back and make our cookies, okay? So now it's been about an hour and we have let our cookie dough chill in the refrigerator, and this is just again about half of what I put in the fridge or what we made earlier. I told you that you could freeze this dough. It freezes extremely well, and so what I did was I just went ahead and wrapped it up in the plastic wrap, and then I put it in a Ziploc bag. I've labeled it what it is, what the date is, okay, and it's pretty simple. Just gonna put this in the freezer. Again, this could stay in the freezer for a few months at least, okay? So that's simple and that's done. And that's cookie dough for another time that I don't have to make. I can just pop it out and I can use those just as cookies because they make just a really good cookie. Or you can make the filling and fill them and make cookie sandwiches. Or again, that would make your Nutter Butter. So let's go ahead and start scooping out our cookies and everything. Because it's peanut butter and there's nut allergies and stuff, even though it's just Tony and I here, I always use gloves just because that's what I did in the bakery. We were really careful anytime we used peanut butter, and that kind of stuck with me. So I'm just gonna glove up here. And I went ahead and I baked some of these so that I could go ahead and fill them for you and they would be easier. So that's why we're working with just a little bit of this dough. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take a cookie scoop. You can just kind of cut this up or just take off chunks of it, just, you know, portion it out, okay? I'm just taking a cookie scoop. And I'm gonna cut it in half. I don't have a smaller scoop that would, because if this would make a big, big cookie, you guys. So I'm just gonna cut it in half, okay? And then we're just gonna roll it in a ball, in our hand, or an ish ball. And then we're gonna roll that in some sugar, okay? All right, that's all we're gonna do, just roll in some sugar. And then put it down on our pan. And we're gonna continue to do that, all right? Now, to get that, these of course would just be circular cookies. To get that true shape, okay? I'm gonna go ahead and just get another scoop of the cookie dough. What this does is just helps me keep my portions even to know how many cookies I'm gonna get out of this batch. All right, so what I'm gonna do to make the quote unquote Nutter Butter shape is you're gonna roll it into a log. And if you look this recipe up, there are instructions to do this. You're just gonna roll it into a log and then roll that in your sugar. And just, you know, put in your sugar, toss it around a little bit. Give it a little love with the sugar, okay? Because a typical peanut butter cookies, you typically would roll it in some just white granulated sugar. So that's what I'm gonna do for a couple of them. All right, pretty redundant process. Just gonna keep going, okay? I'll make one more Nutter Butter shape. I'm sure that there may be a better way, an easier way. This is the way I do it. And this takes forever. This is my least favorite part of making cookies, is having to scoop them out or roll them out because it just takes forever. But I want to show you how we shape them, okay? Just get it into a log. And okay, actually, put all these in one row. Okay, now, fork, stick it in your sugar to kind of just get a little bit on there. And we're just gonna press it down and go the other way. Press it down again. Okay, that's it. That gets your classic peanut butter cookie look. Now for the logs, you're gonna press it just lengthwise on there. Okay. Then we're gonna come back and do two forks on like pretty much just the ends of it, because we're gonna kind of squish it in the middle and it's gonna mess up any shape or any indention that we give it. So what we wanna do is take your first finger and your thumb and kind of just squish in at the middle. You can squish and kind of press down a little bit, maybe bump it together. But you wanna kind of squish it a little bit more than you're like, man, that kind of looks a little weird. It's gonna spread. It's gonna spread when you put it in the oven. So again, we're squishing. I'm gonna press it down a little bit so it's not so smush it in. This is the most time consuming part of this blessed recipe. Anyways, I know it looks kind of weird, but it'll spread. And we're just gonna smush it in the middle. You can form these however you'd like to. Okay. Yep. Okay, so I'm just gonna pop a few more on this pan, all right? Roll it in a ball, roll it in your sugar, okay? And again, we're just using a white granulated sugar. I like to get my process going and kind of get all my balls rolled, and then we'll just, again, roll them in sugar. Let's get them marked. And these look like just small cookies, but they do make a good size cookie. I'll show you how they bake up in just a second. But we are going to put these in a preheated. You need to preheat your oven to 375 degrees. And these are gonna bake a little bit higher. Put a 375 degree oven, and they go this size about 8 minutes, okay? And so I'm gonna pop these in the oven, clean up my mess, and grab my cookies that I've just baked and that are now ready to peel. So our cookies are just out of the oven. We have a pan in there that's got a few more minutes, but you see these Nutter Butter shaped ones or the peanut shaped cookies. This is really hot, so you can, you know, use a spoon if you want to try to get them shaped a little bit better. But just right after they come out of the oven, they're still soft and they're still pliable, so you can shape them to help give you the Nutter Butter or peanut shape that you would prefer. Okay, and if they start to crack a little bit, just push them back together because they will cool and they will be just fine. Oopsie. I'm over here breaking stuff, and that should be okay. If not, you know what, that's our bottom cookie. It's all good in the hood, no worries. All right, and that's, we'll just let them set, let them cool. They'll be good, okay? Our cookies are out of the oven and they are cool and ready for us to go ahead and make our filling so that we can get them filled and sandwiched together. We have another pan that just came out of the oven and one more pan that'll be out in a few minutes. They're a little bit staggered. But as far as the filling goes, the filling is just 2 sticks of butter or 1 cup of softened butter. And then we have 1 cup of creamy peanut butter. I believe you still can use the crunchy peanut butter in this, but again, I pretty much just have the creamy on hand. And so I'm just gonna put this on a low speed and let that whip together, okay, for a minute or so, because my cookies are almost done. And because my butter was so soft, this will whip up in just a hot second, okay? And I'm gonna go ahead and scrape this because it's looking Only it could take a good scraping, and it never hurts to scrape your bowl. Okay. Make sure that we get all those ingredients incorporated well. Okay. So again, we're just gonna let that go. Put it on like a medium to high speed. It'll be fine. Because this is just gonna go in between cookies, so if it gets a lot of air into it, that's fine. If there's air bubbles, that's fine. Also, my oven is screaming at me, so let me grab these out of the oven. And let's see what they look like. All right. And they're done. Looks lovely. Okay. All right. Woo. We've got our peanut-shaped cookies. Everything's good. That looks nice and creamy. So pretty much at this point, all we're gonna do is add our, just gonna give it a good scrape, okay? That's all, just a good scrape. Start adding our powdered sugar. Adjust the amount of sugar in this recipe. If you think that the original recipe's got a little bit more sugar in it, or it's a little sweeter than you like, that's fine. That should have been about a tablespoon of cream. I think we can go a little bit more. The recipe says 2 to 3 tablespoons. I think that'll actually do it. Anytime you put peanut butter in a frosting or in a cake or anything, you can go ahead and get in the bowl. It's going to make it thicker. Okay? It's going to thicken it up. It'll sit there, and it'll get thicker as it sits. So sometimes it's okay to go a little extra on your cream or your liquid so that, you know, it may look a little bit loose now, but later it will firm up. It will season up. It will firm up, and it will be the correct consistency. All right, now let's stop and scrape. Because I see some stuff on the paddle that I want to get. But looks pretty good so far. Right. All right, scrape it again. Okay. Ooh, struggle. Alrighty. A little bit of lumps in there. We're just gonna go ahead and slap it back on there and I actually put another little bit of cream in here just to make sure. If you put too much cream or milk, just put some more powdered sugar. I mean, it'll be okay. Not that big of a deal. It's not waste. I mean, it's not like totally gone. It'll be fine. It can totally be resurrected. Now, to pipe or to get this cream in these cookies. You can, of course, just take, you know, a butter knife or a spoon and, you know, kind of smear it on here and sandwich them together. That's fine. With my history with the bakery and everything, I typically tend to prefer a piping bag. However, this is not always necessary because a good old Ziploc bag will do it for you about every time, okay? And there's a few instances where this is not the best to use or it's a little more difficult to use. But for years and years, I used Ziploc bags to squirt things out onto cookies or cakes or whatever, just because that's what I had, okay? I mean, I've piped many a cupcake out of a Ziploc bag, all right? So, this is looking so lovely. So lovely. Look how light that is. Whew, it's gonna be so good. So wonderful. All right, and yes, I like the way that looks right there. Okay, so I'm just gonna put this in my bag, okay? Take my Ziploc bag, kind of hold it, well, just fold your top down so you don't get it around the top edge of your bag. That's messy and it gets on my nerves. So I'm just gonna fold my top down here. Okay, there, we're gonna fold our top down and just scoop out our icing, drop it in a bag. Okay, that's it. Struggle is real. Okay, so what we want to do is take it, try to push it all to one side, get as much of the air out of it as you can, and twist. That gives us a nice tight grip on this bag. And then we're just gonna cut the bottom off of it, or cut the corner off of it. I would say a cool half inch up. So your hole is about like that, okay? All right, now for these peanut shaped cookies, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna find my matches. So I think that'll work. These two can go together. These two can go together and these two will work. So I'm gonna make him my bottom and him my top. Okay. Right, and that's how we're gonna do it. Get your bottoms and tops together so you don't get confused. And just, you might have to hold your cookie, but just kind of pipe a line, okay? And smoosh. And there you have it. Your cute little peanut butter, peanut shaped cookie. If you want to get super kind of technical, you can kind of go around the edge of the cookie. I apparently didn't do a great job of cutting this bag. You can put as little or as much filling in these as you want to, okay? That is totally up to you. Whatever you like, whatever you think will work. If you're shipping these, maybe put a little less. I have shipped these, they do ship well. Okay. All right, now you can kind of trim, like take a butter knife and trim the excess of that cream away. And I just kind of quickly match these again. Flip them over so I know my tops and my bottoms. I don't do the wrong one. And we're just gonna pipe just a blob in the middle, okay? Just a blob. And then we're gonna smush it. Just push it lightly, gently, okay? You don't wanna Hulk Hogan it, and can I say his name? break it, okay? So just kind of push it down. You're not winning the strength contest here. Just give it a light little tap, all right? And that's what they're looking like, okay, you guys? And this is our peanut butter filled cookie, all right? Our quote unquote nutter butter cookie. I'm gonna just break this in half. You see, that is just so lovely. It's a nice, soft, chewy cookie. That cream is, oh, wonderful. It's not overly sweet. It's just perfect. The peanut butter is so wonderful in that. All right, and so there you have it, your peanut butter sandwich cookies. All right, this, again, I hope you're able to make these. This is how it's made. I follow the recipe. Again, the recipe is from the Cookies and Cups blog. I just Googled Cookies and Cups peanut butter cookies and it'll bring these up. I do like to have my recipes out, okay? And, you know, so that I can make sure that I have everything correct. And I've made these a bunch of times, still don't have that memorized. So I like to make sure I have my recipe out. Thank you guys again for hanging out with us today. Thank you for taking the time to watch this. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to shoot us a message and we'll be glad to help you just as much as we can. Again, I hope you have a wonderful day. Again, I said it before, but live in the light of the Lord and know that no matter what happens, especially in this craziness today, that we know that we're a blessed people and that God has delivered us. Okay? Hope you have a great day. Bye.